Hey guys, Matt with CJ Off-Road here. Today we've got our Gladiator and a bunch of guys in the bed, and we're gonna be putting on some airlift airbags. Now the first thing that I wanted to do while I have all these guys in here is show you how much it squats, and then after I install the bags, we're gonna measure it again and see how much that's changed. I'm gonna start at this rivet, measure right down to our tire, and just to this line, we've got 3¾ inches. And once we install the airlift airbags, I'm gonna re-measure, have these guys hop back in, air it back up, and really show the difference you can make in these bags with some payload in the bed. When you do load up about 1,000 pounds into the bed, you do see a big difference in the way that the bed squats. Now, I know that we don't have a bed rack and rooftop tent, but those are in the plans for the future. And if you already have them, you will notice some squatting in the rear end of your truck. Now, what this airlift bag is going to do is provide you up to 1,000 pounds of force in each bag on the rear suspension of your truck. This will effectively lift up the rear of the truck and keep you at a level ride height while giving you a smoother ride both on and off the road. Make sure to not exceed your factory towing capacity when you have a set of these bags installed. They are also rated up to 35 PSI, and once we have both of them in, we're gonna show you how to run all the air hoses and get them connected to the back. Now this specific model does just have a Schrader valve, and you can fill it up with just a small pump that you probably already have in your Jeep or one at home to the desired PSI, cap it off and let it go. With that being said, we've already got one of these installed, and I'm gonna show you just how easy it is to get these bags installed, so let's get started. So as you can see on this side, we already have the airlift bag installed as well as the rubber isolator up top. Now, the instructions call for you to remove the coil spring in order to get this in. However, you don't need to do that. We got ours in just fine, just by crunching it and putting it in through these coil springs. If you do have a lift kit with some tighter springs, you will need to remove it. But however, with ours, we have the factory springs in the rear, and they do give you a nice gap when you have this elevated. That's another thing I didn't mention. We have this up on the lift. As you can see, I'm standing under it. But if you don't, pick it up by the body and support it by jack stands underneath the frame so that the axle can completely droop. Next thing you want to do is pull off this blue isolating compound. That's on the coil spring. It's held on by a little bit of glue. And you just go ahead and pull that off and toss it. It's not going to go on there or stay on there. So we're going to go ahead and show you how to put this on as well as the isolator up on the other side. So what we're going to do is try and compress the air out of the bag and then put this top end and bend it in through the spring. And then work the bottom end through as well while you're pushing that up. Not too bad, honestly. I just have Brendan here for an extra set of hands because this is the track bar side, so I can't see it as easy. But guys, it really isn't hard to do. Trust us, it's not too bad. Now, he's gonna pull off the isolating compound up top, and we'll show you what it looks like when he pulls it off, but there is some glue on it, so you just gotta pull on it a little bit. As you can see, guys, just some glue holding that on. But if you pull it around, it'll pop right off. And the reason we take this off is so it doesn't interfere when the bag is compressing as well as that isolator on the top. With that being said, let's also throw in the isolator up top. This is gonna be a black rubber piece, and Brendan's gonna slide that in and show you which side to put up. Just push the bag down a little bit. That'll pop over the valve on the top where the airline goes, and then that can be set into place. The next thing we need to do is grab our airline, and we're also gonna grab a small clip, and we're gonna put it in through the top of the bucket mount, and then use a clip onto the airline. So we have this end of the airline run up through the top of the crossmember and down through that black pad that we just installed. After that, you'll wanna slide one of these smaller clamps onto the air hose, and then you're gonna put this end of the air hose onto the top of your brand new airlift bag. Once it's on there, then you'll tighten it down with that clamp, and then we'll move on to the other side. Now that we've got the airline run across the crossmember, what we've got to do is add in our T-fitting. Now we're going to go ahead and cut it right here, add in the T-fitting, and then we'll follow the excess wire up along this wiring harness to the back bumper where we can put in our Schrader valve. But right now we're just going to cut it, install that T-fitting, and then we can get this bag pumped up and run the line to the back. So basically what we're doing here is he's putting the other side of the line into this bag, and then we're gonna run that back to the T and then take one air hose all the way back towards the rear bumper. We'll have to drill a small hole and put the Schrader valve in. We've got the two side pieces connected with the clamps. The last step is to connect the center one for us to run one air valve for both of these bags. We're gonna go ahead and slide it on and then tighten the clamp on that. We'll show you the valve on the back and then tighten it all down. So what we've decided to do is put the air fill up here, one in the factory location, where one of these push pins are. Now, all we did was pull out one of the push pins and push this through the back with the valve facing us. As you can see, it gets a rubber washer, a standard washer, and then a nut. And once you get it all tightened down, you can finish it off with the included cap. Well, what we're gonna do is get everything all connected. Obviously, you can see that spun, so we need to get this fully tightened down. Get the air hose on the back with the one last clamp that we have, and we'll be good to go. So you can use a half inch socket or a half inch box wrench just to get this nice and snugged up. You can see the rubber's compressed there and everything's good and tight. Once that's on, go ahead and connect the Schrader valve cap, put that on there and make sure this is all good to go. Double check all your air lines throughout the vehicle and zip tie any air lines up and out of the way of any hot surfaces and make sure they're not gonna rub against anything when you're going down the trail. But besides that, we're done with this install. We're gonna lower the truck down and I'll show you that exact same shot we did in the beginning. But I'm really happy with how this went, so let's lower it down. All right guys, so about an hour later, we've installed these bags and everything is wired up and plumbed the way it needs to be. I've asked some volunteers to hop in the bed again and we're gonna measure to see what kind of difference this made. Now remember before we were under 4 inches, so the bed had actually dropped over 2 inches by putting, you know, a couple guys in the back, which would simulate a rooftop tent, a couple other things in there. So we're gonna go ahead and measure at the same exact point. And you can see instead of dropping almost 2 inches, we've only dropped about a quarter of an inch. So that is definitely a huge improvement on these airlift bags to the back end of this Gladiator. And I highly suggest them if you are gonna be running various loads in the back, if you're gonna be towing, hauling, things like that, you can change up the bags to really match your driving style or where you're gonna be taking your Jeep. Now, if you wanna check these out as well as many other great parts, be sure to visit us at cjponyparts.com. Hope you enjoyed that video. To stay up to date on our CJ Off-Road videos, make sure to subscribe up top here. And for any other installs, make sure to click the link right above.